In this session, I'm going to talk about data upload in Business Central. So many people want to load their own customers, vendors, inventory items, etc. And what Business Central has is called a configuration package. So I'm going to start typing in configuration. And there we have configuration packages. So what we're doing is we're going to build a package that gives you a template that you could load, update your data, your customers, vendors, etc., and then upload it into Business Central rather than have to do one at a time. So I'm simply going to go to New, and in this example, I'm just going to talk about customers. You can do this for customers, vendors, inventory items, just about every single table within Business Central. But let's stick with customers. And give it a code, give it its related name, and then I'm just going to shoot right down to the table ID. Here is where we tell what table we want to upload our data. So I'm going to click on this little button here, the ellipse button, three little dotted. Obviously, you don't know the ID numbers. Not many people do. So you could always do a search of saying, okay, I want to upload my customers. So I'm going to type in customer, and lo and behold, there's my customer table. Okay, this is the table ID number, and this is the related description of the table. And obviously, customer coincides with what we're looking for. So I'm going to choose customer, tab off it. And then once I tab off it, it's going to ask you, you have two tables. You're not going to get this all the time. Depends on what you're trying to upload. But it's basically related tables that goes that coincide with the customers. You can look at them and see if you want to check them out or no. I typically hit no because right now all I really care about is loading my customer information. And these related tables are something typically like, you know, payment terms that you there's another subtable that you have to update and so forth. So you could actually load payment terms at the same time or payment methods, scenarios like that. I'm just going to hit no because I would just want to concentrate on just the customer itself. So now that I have the customer table, what I can also do is if I go up to my table and go to fields, this is going to show you all the fields that reside in the customer table. And you'll see there's a great deal of fields. Now, if I was to create this template, it's going to bring in the template that has all these fields, and all these fields are overwhelming. There's just too many of them, right? So what I can do is I could clear them all out. And of course, you see this one is still checked off because that's the number field. You have to have the customer number. That's your key field. So that you cannot clear out. But I cleared everything out. And then I'm going to go to edit list. Matt, sometimes you actually will have to click it twice to really make it into edit. And then I can mainly select what fields I want to update or populate when I do this upload. So obviously I want a customer name, obviously, right? Address to, city, have a contact, phone number. And I start going down and look for all the names of the fields that I want to put in there. Credit limit, yeah, I want to update my credit limit. A posting group is a mandatory field, so I want to choose that. If I'm dealing with currency, I could choose that. And you're going to go right down the line, payment terms. So you're going to select what fields that you want to populate when we do this upload. Okay. What we can also do is if I want to resort these, because you'll see it's not really, unfortunately, not a nice, easy sequence, right? So I got address to, city, but where's my state and zip code, right? Well, the state and zip code is really all the way further down. Okay, just as an example. So if I keep on scrolling down, here's my postcode. So postcode is zip code and county is actually the city. So it's way down here. If I really want to bring, I could either leave it as is, or I could actually bring it all the way up by using this move up, move down. It is one character at a time, one line at a time. So I would have to go all the way and keep on clicking to bring this all the way up if I chose to. Okay, I'm not going to go all the way up there, but I can do that. So that way it's a nice way, a nice flow when I update my Excel template. Okay, So now that I'm happy and I'm content with all the fields, then I'm going to close out. I'm going to close out again, and you'll see I have my customers. And the first step I'm going to do is create that template. And this template's going to allow you to update. It's Excel-based. And then once that's updated with the data, your raw data, then we'll run the routine of actually populating it in Business Central. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to Package, Export to Excel. And this exports any existing data that's in there. And in this case, you'll see I have already five customers in there. Okay, so what I can do is I either can leave these customers as is, or I can update them, because if I update any of this, whether I update the name, address, whatever I change, it's going to find the match and say, oh, so in trade research, maybe I want to update a PO box. So I could do PO box, 123. So what it's going to do, once it finds an update, it's going to say, oh, there's a change. So this change is going to actually populate this one change. So basically it kind of replaces all the data. So if it's all the same, then you're not going to know any different, right? And then from here, I could start adding new ones. So here's 60,000, and this is my new customer. And I'm going to go 1 Main Street, and I'll do Suite 55, and so forth, right? And I'll just stop there. Well, I'll do, did I know this is a mandatory? My credit limit is going to be $100, okay? So I could add all, so, and I'm just going to go to my next number. Of course, you need to give it the number. So it's 7,000, and I'll just do second customer, and I'll just stop there, because you'll get the point. You could just add, you're going to add to the existing customers. Or if you don't, if you're afraid you don't want to change any of the data itself, then you could actually go ahead and delete these lines if you feel that you don't want them any longer. Okay. Please do not change any of the columns. You can't add columns. You can't delete columns. You can't move them around. Well, technically, of course, you can, but that's going to throw the template off because it is a fixed template. This is the way you spit it out is the way it needs to go back in. So once you start playing with the columns, like I said, delete, add, or change them around, it's not going to work anymore. It's just not going to update the data like you want it to. So as you create this template, it has to stay and remain the same. So I just added these two new customers, and now I'm going to go ahead and save. And I'll say new customers. And I'll close this out. Now I could go back into, I'm going to just escape out, kind of start fresh. So then once I get that file all prepared and ready, I'm going to go back into the configuration packages, go to my customers, and go to package. And instead of exporting that create my template, I'm going to import from Excel. And then you go find your file. And let's see, documents, no downloads, new customers. And what it's telling you, this kind of verification, this is what you're going to be updating, customer number table 18. So you verify that. I'm going to click on import. And what it did is it imported it into basically a temporary table. Okay, think of it that way. What it just did is I uploaded a table, one table, which was table customers, and number of records 7. If you remember, I had existing 5 and I added 2. So here's my 7 records. So it kind of went into a temporary tape. Basically, it went into like a, to ensure that the format of the file was good. And so far, so good. Now you do need to have a second step. And this is what's called apply package. And now you're actually going to truly apply these new changes and additions to your table. So I'm going to go to process, apply package. And it's going to ask me, are you ready to do it? I say, yes, I am. And it's going to confirm that one table was processed, no errors found, which is excellent, because if you do have an error, you need to find out what that error was. two records were inserted, obviously, as you saw that, and one record was modified. Remember, I put in that PO box. So that's everything that I expected. That's great. That's good. This will also show me my errors. If I did have any errors, this would give me a number. If I found one or two errors, it would tell you here. Then you could drill down into finding it, and it'll tell you what the error is. So you could go back based on what the error tells you. You could go and fix that error, whether it's in the data file itself or maybe it's a missing setup, whatever the case may be, right? You'll find it here. Okay, I'm going to escape out. I'm going to go back to my customers. And you'll see here's my new customer and second customer. If I go into my new customer, you'll see here's my $100 credit limit, 1 Main Street, Suite 55. Okay, let's go into, I think I did Tray Research, where I added PO Box 123. Okay, so that's how you can update in mass quantities of your records, whether it be a customer, whether I do a vendor, inventory item, or any smaller tables I feel like I want to update rather than doing it one at a time within the Business Central itself. So thanks for watching. If there's any further assistance we can do for you, please reach out to us here at epcgroup.net.